and look forward to this time that we can share together and worship together. Before we begin our service, I have just a couple of announcements to go over. First of all, we have the regular occurrence of Sunday school classes on Tuesday, but church school classes on Tuesday. That makes more sense to say it that way. But we have the adult classes for theology and Bible study at 7 o'clock on Tuesday. You can join via the Zoom link. And we also then have junior senior high Wednesday at 7 p.m. via the Zoom link. So mark your calendar for those. The other announcement that I have is that today, immediately following the morning service, we will be having our annual business meeting for the review and approval of the upcoming year's budget. So when the service concludes here, we'll have a few minutes of fellowship while we prepare for the business meeting, and then we'll join right back into our business meeting afterwards. So I would encourage anyone who can to stay for that as we go through and address the business needs of the congregation for next year. And I would encourage that here in the sanctuary as well as online on Zoom as well. Finally, we have prayer concerns this morning to raise to the congregation. Prayer concerns and grateful news can be raised to Carol White by end of day Thursday for inclusion in Sunday morning's gathering as a congregation. And this week, we have four prayer concerns that we are raising to the congregation. We have Trent P., who is experiencing heart issues. Trent is a young infant and is experiencing heart issues. We have Deanna C., who has been diagnosed with cancer. Prayers for Vilma and her family, as the family has recently experienced a death within the family. And then finally, as many of you have seen, there have been strong and devastating tornadoes that have occurred, and prayers for all who are impacted by that event. So this morning, our prayer on behalf of the congregation will be given by Cheryl. But as she comes forward and then offers a prayer, I would encourage each of you individually to offer your own silent prayer at the same time.
Would you please bow with me and pray? Our God and eternal Father, we come together as a community of believers and followers in prayer for your children and our brothers and sisters today. Recognizing our world is hurting and in deep pain, we thank you for your great enduring love and for your Holy Son, whom we celebrate in this season of hope, joy, love, and peace. As we respond to your Holy Spirit, may we become an extension of Jesus' hands and feet and become a blessing to others as we relate to those we greet and meet. Help us be more like Jesus and less like us. Trent P. has been diagnosed with heart issues. May he, his family, and friends feel your love and compassion as they go through this time. Guide his medical team to resolve his issues. Deanna C. has cancer. As her medical team works on treatments, plans, may they be guided by your Holy Spirit. May she feel your love and comfort and guidance and confidence and strength in your blessing. Be with her family and friends with comfort for them. Velma A. has a death in the family, a season of mourning, for this family. May each one be blessed with your love and comfort as you hold them in your arms. The tornado outbreak victims with loss of life, physical structures, and so much more, first responders, volunteer helpers, there and on the way. May they all feel your compassion, your love, your comfort, and healing hands as you bless each one according to their special needs and circumstances. In the name of the Holy One, Jesus Christ, amen.
As we begin our service this morning, I do want to cover one piece of housekeeping before we get started. And this is for everyone here physically as well as everyone remote. And as a part of our service this morning, we will be going through a spiritual practice. And during that time, you'll be asked to write down, I'll guide you through it, but you'll be asked to write down some things that are just for you. But then the question is, what are you going to write on? And for everyone at home, we're going to be singing a couple hymns here in just a little bit, and that'll be a great opportunity for you to go get a piece of paper and a pencil or pen as we prepare for that portion of the service when we get there. Here in the sanctuary, same thing still applies, and we have index cards at the back of the sanctuary, and Audrey and Addison will assist by getting those, and if during the hymns you just raise your hand, they'll come and bring you an index card. And if you need something to write with, we've got some pens as well. So just be aware of that. But during these opening hymns, we want to make sure that everybody gets what they need for that portion of the service. I welcome you here to our Sunday morning service as we celebrate the third Sunday of Advent. And today we are focused on joy. When you think of joy, and you think of the Christmas season, you cannot miss by connecting the dots that joy and Christmas means songs and singing. And so today's service will be filled with many of our favorite Christmas songs as we worship together this morning. And we will do that by beginning with the two hymns that I talked about earlier. So please join me now as we sing two carols of the season. We'll be singing What Child Is This? And we'll also be singing Silvery Star, Precious Star. Both hymns will be led by the Beyond the Walls Choir. And as a reminder, those in the sanctuary, as we sing hymns, you can have your mask off during the service. But as we're singing hymns, I ask that you put the mask on during the singing of the hymn. So at this time, we'll go into What Child Is This?
Shepherds watch thy keeping.
And our next hymn will be Silvery Star, Precious Star. That's hymn number 419 in your hymnal, if you want to look there. And we'll remain seated for that as well.
I'm so sorry.
Good morning. How was your week?
Remember when we talked about Jesus's love last week and that I was supposed to love that guy who really got on my nerves?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I tried to treat him as Jesus would have, and I found out the guy isn't nearly as bad as I thought. Not sure I can say I love you yet, but...
That's wonderful. Don't worry. It gets easier the more you try.
I surveyed my friends and asked if they knew about agape love. Not many of them did, so I explained it to them.
Wow, that's terrific, Audrey. Did it give you any joy to do that?
Joy? I don't know if I would say that, but it felt good.
I asked about joy because that's what this Sunday is about.
You mean happiness, laughing, that sort of thing?
Not exactly. It's a different kind of joy.
More like well-being than delight.
Yes, but it's about how Jesus talks about joy. The best thing is that both of you have already started down the road of Jesus's kind of joy.
Huh?
This joy goes together with the love we talked about last week. Let me read from the Bible in the Gospel of John, chapter 15. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete.
I think I get it. God's love for Jesus is the same as Jesus has for us, right?
Yep, keep going.
And if we love as Jesus taught, we will have joy?
Yes, by keeping the great commandment, we will have joy.
Is that the one that says we are to love the Lord with all our heart, soul, and mind, and also to love our neighbor as ourselves? I don't even know my neighbors.
Well, it's a good time to meet them and show them some love.
Really?
And neighbor refers to everyone on the planet. When you really love and care for all people equal to yourself, you'll
experience joy.
Exactly. You do get it.
So that's what I felt when I delivered food to those families and was kind of that guy that really bugs me. And when I told my friends about God's love.
Yes, that's it.
This Advent stuff is really educational and fun.
Just wait for next week. It's my favorite one.
What is it?
You'll just have to wait and see.
Okay.
I know you wouldn't ask me, but would you like to light the candle next week?
Thank you for asking. That would be great.
Be good this week.
You bet. I will. I want more of that joy.
Yeah, so y'all can't go too far away.
I was gonna say.
Yeah.
All right, so... thank you for that. And we're actually going to try something a little bit different this week. And Audrey and Addison and Aaliyah are going to help lead us through that. So it's not uncommon for us to do a responsive reading during the course of a service. This week, we're going to try something different, which is a responsive singing. So if you think about at Camp Cienito during campfires, at times, there'll be a song that will be what we call a repeat after me song. And so the leader will sing a line and then you just sing that exact same line back again. We're gonna do that as a responsive singing this morning. Up on the screen, it will show the lines. There's like four lines, so it's not real hard. But Audrey and Addison and Aaliyah will sing it through, sing the line the first time. Then they'll also lead us singing through as everybody joins in, and this will all be done a cappella. Everybody ready? Everybody got it? Good? All right, here we go.
Joy is a song, joy is a song, joy is a song for all to sing. Joy is a song for all to sing. Light the candle of joy, light the candle of joy.
God of joy, I'm sorry, is it time for me to do the prayer piece?
It is, Cindy, you're right.
Okay, great.
You're right on.
Okay. God of joy, sometimes it is hard for us to remember that you created both tears of sadness and tears of joy. We see so many situations for which we empathize. Families in need of food, lonely people in search of friendship, animals in search of new homes, and earth in need of rest. You are with us. We see your hand at work in creating peace in our communities. May we join you in creating this peace. We pray for the lonely, the hungry, the homeless, and the tired. And now, please strengthen us to hug, to feed, to provide, and to care for all in need. Fill us with your joy as we strive to share peace. May our joy overflow and bless those we serve. In the name of your Son, Jesus, the one we wait for and who gives us great joy. Amen.
Thank you, Cindy. And now please join me in singing our hymn of peace. It's hymn number 402, and it is Peace Child. And this will be led by the Cole Choir. I'd mentioned at the beginning of the service that there was going to be a spiritual practice in the course of the service, and this is where that index card or a piece of paper might come in handy for you. I'd like you to get that out if you could. As we talk about joy, one of the things that we also need to recognize is that an awareness of our blessings can bring us joy. That gratitude for those blessings in our lives, for those things that have occurred, which sustain us, which enrich us, which take us to a new place that we had never experienced before. Those moments in our lives, whether they are years back or they are very recent and even today, those moments of blessings, the gratitude for those occurrences can bring us joy. And so for today's spiritual practice, what we'd like to do is have you list or draw or somehow share, and this is just for you, on your piece of paper, three of your favorite blessings or those blessings that come to mind. And once again, those can be very recent and those can be very early on in your life. What we're going to do is just take a few minutes of silence as you capture those and write those down and reflect on your Heavenly Parents' blessing your life. If you're still writing, I would continue to keep doing so. It would not surprise me if three seemed limiting, that more might have come to mind, or as you wrote one, it reminded you of another one. We are fortunate. And to continue the spiritual practice of joy throughout your week, I would invite you to keep this card with you, to keep this piece of paper that you have written on with you throughout the week. Take it with you where you go, or leave it beside your bed and reflect on it in the evenings. But as the week unfolds, and as you think of or experience additional blessings, write them down. Remind yourself of the blessings that you have. Take time, pause, and be grateful. May you feel joy knowing that you are loved and are blessed. And now let's sing together hymn number 427. This is Angels We Have Heard on High, very uplifting song. Hymn number 427, and this once again is led by the Beyond the Walls Choir. Those in sanctuary, please put on your mask as you sing, and we will once again remain seated for the singing of this hymn, hymn number 427. Today's Advent scripture of joy comes from Zephaniah chapter 3, verses 14 and then 17 through 20. Sing, daughter of Zion, shout aloud, Israel. Be glad and rejoice with all of your heart, daughter Jerusalem. The Lord your God is with you, the mighty warrior who saves. He will take great delight in you, in his love. He will no longer rebuke you, but will rejoice over you with singing. I will remove from you all who mourn over the loss of your appointed festivals, which is a burden and reproach for you. At that time, I will deal with all who oppressed you. I will rescue the lame. I will gather the exiles. I will give them praise and honor in every land where they have suffered shame. At that time, I will gather you. At that time, I will bring you home. I will give you honor and praise among all the peoples of the earth when I restore your fortunes before your very eyes, says the Lord. And I'd ask now that once again, we are going to sing another hymn. Please join me as we sing and rejoice with one of our most joyful hymns. And you can't avoid but be joyful as you sing this one. Hymn number 408, Joy to the World. We'll be led by the Beyond the Walls choir. And then immediately following this will be this morning's message brought to us by Lila Gardner.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come, let earth receive her King, let every heart prepare Him room, and heaven and nature sing, as heaven and nature sing, as heaven and nature sing. Joy to
Good morning. It is with joy that I come to you today. What a glorious day. You have just recently heard Richard read our scripture lesson for today, which comes from the third chapter of Zephaniah. Zephaniah is one of what is known as one of the minor prophets. The book of Zephaniah was probably written between 640 and 609 BCE. The scholars always quibble about things, little details like that. But the best we can tell, that's probably what it was. And the best we can tell, the book was probably written to the people of Judah who experienced domination and oppression from the Assyrians and the Babylonians. Most of the book of Zephaniah is filled with doom and gloom. But when we get to the third chapter, Zephaniah is a very short book, only three chapters. When we get to that third chapter, which is where our scripture lesson for today comes, we find finally some reassuring words. We find a reassuring promise that everything is going to turn out okay because, as it states in verse 17, the Lord your God is with you. Here, God is described as a loving, exalting person. And he's wishing to protect his children. He wants to bring them a spirit of joy, not of fear. God does this by saying he is with us, as it says in verse 17. Even when we have trials and tribulations, stress, oppression, lack of food, lack of water, all of those things that happen to us. He reassures the people that he is with them, which also means he is with us. The people of Judah were facing great challenges, But today in our time, we too are facing great challenges ourselves. This story helps us recognize that God's blessings are for all people. As Zephaniah states in verse 20, I will give you honor and praise among all the people on the earth. Notice he did not say, I will give honor and praise to people, to some people above on the earth, but he said, I will give honor and praise to those among others. That's a big difference there. That brings to mind our enduring principle, the worth of all people, and also the enduring principle, unity and diversity. On this Advent Sunday of joy, let us remember Jesus Christ is God with us. Jesus was called Emmanuel, which means God with us. God took human form to be fully with us and blesses all people and shows us the way to complete love, hope, joy, and peace. Regardless of our circumstances, we can accept that God is with us. Because of that, we need not fear. Instead, we can experience joy in unbelievable ways. We can rejoice with all our hearts. This is good news for any time and any age. Our theme for today, as you heard, is sing and rejoice. Some people are really great singers. We have a lot of great singers in our family, in the cold between the Gold family and the Gardner family. But even if we aren't great singers, that doesn't delay us or keep us from belting out a song in joy if we are filled with the Spirit of the Lord. If you've ever been to our world conference in Independence, Missouri, and heard the delegation from Tahiti sing, you have heard people sing who are filled with the Spirit of the Lord. They are absolutely marvelous. Anytime I've heard them, they just lift you up. They sing with such spirit. The Lord has provided us songs to express our feelings of both happiness and sadness. Now I want to share with you some scriptures from both the Old and the New Testament that proclaim six reasons why we sing and rejoice. Number one, sometimes we sing for freedom. In Psalm 68:6, we read, God sets the lonely in families and leads out the prisoners with singing. If we look back at the history of our country, we recognize that the slaves many years ago would sing as they toiled in the fields, dreaming of their future freedom. A song that we associate with freedom today is We Shall Overcome. It's in our hymnal, number 261. I'm just going to give you the condensed version of the lyrics for that song. We shall overcome someday. We shall walk hand in hand someday. We shall live in peace someday. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe that we shall overcome someday. Because of our freedom in Christ, we find great joy in singing with all our hearts to the Lord. The second reason that we can sing for joy is because of God's love. In Psalm 89:1, it says, I will sing to the Lord, I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known through all generations. We are loved by God even when we are unlovable. His unconditional love gives us a reason to sing of his goodness and grace in our lives. God expressed his love through the birth, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ for every person on this planet. Number three, we sing of what God has done. Psalm 132:9 states, "Sing to him, sing praises to him, tell of all his wonderful acts." In Isaiah 42:10, we read, "Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise from the ends of the earth." God has done and continues to do great things. There are new things to sing every day, new songs to sing every day, because he's always doing new things in our lives. We can look to him to refresh our spirits when we are low with a new song of joy and peace. Our part of this newness is to be aware, humble, and open to what the Lord is doing in our lives. Singing gives us an opportunity to speak out about what God has done. Number four. Another reason we sing is for joy. Psalm 132:9 states, "May your faithful people sing for joy." Singing is a great expression of joy for the Lord and for his wonderful works for us. Joy from the Lord cannot be restrained when we know and sense his presence in the world, in our lives. The world can offer temporary happiness, but the joy that God gives us lasts eternally. One of my favorite hymns of rejoicing is 112, "I will sing, I will sing." Briefly, the lyrics are, I will sing a song unto the Lord. Alleluia, glory to the Lord." Psalm 104:33 tells us, "I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God while I have being." The beauty of knowing Christ is that songs of rejoicing can last our entire lives. We can never outgrow the wonder of God or his marvelous hand over our lives. Number five. Another reason that we sing and rejoice is to express gratitude. That's confirmed in Colossians 3:16-17. "Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, with gratitude in your hearts. Sing songs, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him." The author, Douglas Wood, links happiness and thankfulness. He says, "The heart that gives thanks is a happy one, for we cannot feel thankful and unhappy at the same time." The more we say thanks, the more we find to be thankful for. And the more we find to be thankful for, the happier we become. Douglas Wood says, "We don't give thanks because we are happy. We are happy because we give thanks." We have a reason to sing with gratitude to the Lord every time we awake to a new day filled with grace and mercy. Many times we forget to express our gratefulness in the busyness of our lives. One of our hymns of gratitude that I like is number 614, "My gratitude now accept, O God." The first verse of the hymn of that hymn goes like this: "My gratitude now accept, O God, for tender care that you provide, for your abundant faithfulness, endless is your supply." Number six, Ephesians 5:19-20 tells us to sing from the heart. Be filled with the Spirit as you sing hymns and songs and spiritual songs among yourselves, singing and making melody to the Lord in your hearts, giving thanks to God for all the times and all the things and everything in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. There are many people associated with the knowledge of God, but they don't know him in their hearts. That can also be true with singing to the Lord. In order for us to be true, to truly connect and know the Lord in song, we must know him in our hearts. That means knowing Jesus Christ and living out his commandments. Today we live in a troubled world. You might ask, how can it be possible to acknowledge the realities of life as difficult as they may be, and still celebrate life with joy as a gift from God? The answer is found in the joy that comes from the relationships that we have with others and with God. Joy is a fruit of the Spirit. It cannot be programmed or manufactured. Joy is a byproduct of the development of true community among those who have committed themselves to a life based on gospel principles. Joy arises as our community life is anchored to a faith in God's purposes being fulfilled and linked to the life of the Spirit. Our enduring principles lead the way. Number one, grace and generosity. Number two, sacredness of creation. Number three, continuing revelation. Number four, the worth of all persons. Number five, all are called. Number six, making responsible choices. Number seven, the pursuit of peace. Number eight, unity in diversity. And number nine, blessings of community. No matter what reason you have for singing, be it for freedom, for God's love, for what God has done, for joy, to express gratitude, singing from the heart, or any other reason, if we will follow our enduring principles, we will find joy. Sing and rejoice.
Well, it's now time for the disciples' generous response. And I'm going to read, yes, I am going to read, the words of Apostle Carlos Enrique Mejia. Hey, I got it right. He serves over the Central and South American mission field. And these are his words. And as we go through these words, you will see different slides that will appear on the screen to my left and your right. The whole world has been impacted by COVID-19 pandemic. Many people have been infected. Others have lost their loved ones to the disease. This situation keeps many of us at home, taking care of ourselves and our families, church activities and worship services at buildings in many places are still suspended. And up until now, it has been impossible to hold them in person. Schools, companies, businesses are closed. This left many people out of work and without income. The lack of food has been the worst. All pastors care for our members, and it was necessary to resort to using reserves from the local offerings to feed families. Brother Gonzalo Mejia, president of the Central American Mission Center, made an invitation to all pastors of the rural areas to encourage members who grow staple grains to give according to their capacity to provide for sisters and brothers from their congregation in the urban areas who worked in the factories and were out of work and were struggling to feed their families. The response was immediate. Pastors of Copeland area in Honduras, where we have three rural congregations, called to tell us that they had more than 2,000 pounds of food they had collected from among themselves and communities of people who are not members of the church. We took all necessary precautions and drove there. We took two vehicles to bring this food. Let me tell you, brothers and sisters, it was a unique experience to see the joy of the people sharing. But it was even more surprising that after loading the vehicles, the pastor told me, "Apostle, the brothers and sisters joyously collected cash to help, and he gave me the equivalent of about 35 US dollars. This amount may not seem like much money, but for the difficult financial circumstances they live in, this represents almost 6 days worth of salary for one person." I believe the witness and action of these brothers and sisters speak to their generosity, solidarity, and the joy of supporting people in need. Brothers and sisters, this whole experience reminded me of the church who, in the midst of a great trial of affliction, poured out its generosity and provided for other people with joy. It is wonderful what the Doctrine and Covenants 169:9 tells us. Faithful disciples respond to an increasing awareness of the abundant generosity of God by sharing according to the desires of their hearts, not by commandment or constraint. Break free of the shackles of conventional culture that mainly promote self-serving interest. Give generously according to your true capacity. Internal joy and peace await those who grow in grace of generosity that flows from compassionate hearts without thought of return. Quite a story, don't you think? And the pictures definitely add to the story. During the disciples' response, we focus on aligning our hearts with God's heart. Now, there are offerings of gifts, and we are able to tangibly express our gratitude to God, who is the giver of all. But here's something that many of us probably may not know. For over a year now, Shenandoah congregation has been accepting donations to help fight food insecurity in our local community. by the end of 2021 calendar year, we have been able to send approximately $1,500 to the San Antonio Food Bank and $1,500 to the Christian Assistance Ministry for a total of $3,000. And we would like to thank you for your generosity. So as we comes today and as we prepare to give our offering to our Lord, there are different ways to do that. There is a plate back on the stand that you can drop your donation at if you choose. You can go to our website at www.seaofchrist.org, SA.org. And it's a link that I use often, and it works very well. So that is another option, or you can do it through e-tithing, or you could mail a check to Kathleen as well. So we have many options to use to contribute to help us do God's work here in the Shenandoah congregation and for the World Church also. So if you will bow with me, I will say a prayer. Our dear, kind, gracious Heavenly Father, we are so grateful to be here. We are grateful for the opportunity for us to share what we have to help the mission of spreading God's gospel, taking care of our facilities, taking care of people in need, and many other opportunities that present themselves that are unknown to us. Lord, we ask that you bless us, that you bless the monies that we provide, that you bless the talents that we give, and bless us for reaching out to those who are in need. For this, we do ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Thank you, Earl. And at this time, we will now close our service by standing and singing our final hymn of the morning, which is hymn number 423, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. This will be led by the Beyond the Walls Choir as well. Remind you, please, in the sanctuary, please put your mask on as you sing. Hymn number 423, Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, hold and see.
me, please. Our Lord, we are so thankful for this time that we have had to join together to share in your word this morning and to feel your love and to sense the joy that comes from you. Lord, we thank you for the blessings that we have had in our lives. We thank you for the gift of the birth of your son and the example that he provided for us so many years ago and which we still to this day aspire to meet. Please be with us in the coming week is our prayer in Christ's name. Amen. At this time, as a reminder, we will have a business meeting for the approval of the budget for next year coming up. But while we set up, if you would like to, you can join in fellowship. You can unmute your lines if you're remote, and we can chat for a bit, and then we'll begin in about 5 minutes. If you do not have a hard copy here in the sanctuary of the budget, for those online, we will be displaying that as we discuss it. But if you do not have a hard copy, there are some in the back, and Keith will help you get a copy of the budget for review. All right? We'll begin here in about 5 minutes. I think